are looking at a CO2 capture unit and a reactor equipped with electrical resistance tomography sensors, 16 of them around this reactor. I will start with CO2 capture unit and why we are using it, I will explain later. This is a glass vessel that we are using. We are adding our absorbent solution inside the whole CO2 unit. There is a pump in there that circulates that absorbent solution into the unit. It goes like this part here, where there is a hollow fiber membrane contactor. And with pressure difference at the bottom and top, the liquid again circulates inside the solution. End-to-end air comes from here, and CO2 gas, carbon dioxide, comes from the CO2 bottle over there, and enters the unit from here, which is controlled by our LabVIEW program in real time by the user. We have a couple of heat exchangers here to control the temperature and to regulate and adjust the temperature based on operating conditions and to investigate the different scenarios that would happen with different solutions. In our demonstration purposes, we are not using extensive temperature control. We are monitoring it, but we are not using higher temperatures, just around 25 degrees, 20 degrees of operating temperature. The absorbent solution in our case is sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is higher concentrations of sodium hydroxide can be used to absorb CO2 gas CO2 gas. Let's say we are using for our operation here pH 14 of sodium hydroxide as the absorbent solution. As we are as CO2 is being absorbed into the unit, the pH lowers down, the pH decreases until it reaches some specific limit. Based on our chemical analysis, pH 12 is our target, in which we stop the CO2 absorption, and we have a CO2 loaded solution which has carbonate ions that can be used with calcium chloride inside the reactor to form calcium carbonate as solid particle. So what we're doing is we're binding CO2 gas, let's say from atmosphere, but we are using that bottle in order to model that. CO2 gas, we are using it, and we're binding that gas to solid particle formation. Basically, the idea is carbon capture and utilization. We are getting the carbon dioxide and utilize it as the form of calcium carbonate. When the CO2 capture has ended, the reagent that we have, which is carbon ions and sodium ions inside, they come from this feed pipe and they go into the reactor. In the reactor, we have calcium sources. This calcium, in our application, is calcium chloride. It can be any other, of course, calcium sources as well. This reactor is equipped with a Russian impeller with 16 electrodes of ERT, electrical resistance tomography. And our aim is part of the Tomocom project is we are demonstrating the application of electrical resistance tomography for real-time process monitoring and control of the process. But our approach is use this ERT, electrical resistance tomography sensors, as a tool for process malfunction analysis. Process consists of few critical steps, like one of them is mixing, one of them is pump, one of them is the reagent concentration, one of them is also calcium chloride inside the reactor. So these four situations are in this process are critical. Because if one of them goes wrong, we have a failure, different extent of failure, but let's say it's mixing itself affects the particle quality. Also same goes for the feed and the concentration, initial concentration of the absorbent solution. So we are using the ERT sensor live and real time online and monitor the process with our LabVIEW program. The LabVIEW program is developed by using only one of the ERT sensor data, we have chosen this one, which is closer to the feed. It has a higher sensitivity to, this, to the incoming situations and conditions in, inside the reactor. We are using that data, and we have identified how different situations affect ERT readings, ERT measurements. And the LabVIEW program gives the user this ability to monitor the situations in real time, and in case one of them fails, let's say mixer fails or the pump fails, we know the signal, we have analyzed the signal, and we are using that to, adding, to our advantage. I give one example. Mixing and feed and the process is ongoing, crystallization is okay, but at T plus 5, we had a failure of the mixer, mixer stops. The signal that we get in that situation is different than the signal that the mixer is on. And based on this data analysis in the lab view, and based on the standard deviation or the amplitude of the signals, we get a user message. We get a message to the user in the program that says the mixer is off, so repair it. This is real-time monitoring. We have not implemented the coming back online, like the control of the mixer when it has this malfunction, but it shows the user, which user can, of course, control and apply the appropriate actions. Same situation is for the feed pump. And also we can identify the concentration when we have the reagent, standard reagent, or we are adding just random water. We know the differences, and we can see in the LabVIEW program. This is the whole summary, a brief summary of extensive experimental campaign done in April 2021 as the Tomocon batch crystallization demonstration in electrical resistance tomography.